Runway. Today is the final casting call for Project Runway.
20 people are coming, but only 16 will make the competition.
Do you support yourself by being a designer?
I do. I guess I would rather be poor and hungry than go back to my previous career.
Which was?
Banking.
When did you learn how to sew?
I just learned.
So you just learned how to sew?
Stopped designing about 1992. I was fortunate enough to work for three of America's top designers, Bill Blass, Arnold Skazi, and Alston. I'm sober now about almost 3 years, and it's wonderful designing again.
I think you just have to be careful to not be too simple. Congratulations. You're all now our designers at Project Runway.
Rise and shine, everyone. What you were wearing and the one sheet that you brought are the materials for this challenge.
Oh my God. I'm having problems with my model. There was definitely some fit issues.
Is that a toilet?
The pants are off-putting.
She's wearing like a Flintstone disco pouch.
You are in a competition, and you are going to show me a pair of white shorts and a tank top.
Bert, you are the winner of this challenge.
I won.
Really? Josh, you're in, but barely. A fail. That means you're out.
This
is the search for the next big fashion designer.
Yes.
16 designers.
It's about style.
Fashion.
Attitude.
How do I have attitude? Attitude.
3 finals. I would wear that.
I think it's fantastic.
Well, let me see you put it on.
Keep me out of this.
And 1 winner.
This is for real.
Be good.
Be great.
This is Project Runway.
The winner of Project Runway will receive $100,000 from L'Oréal Paris to start their own line, a fashion spread in Marie Claire magazine, a $50,000 technology suite from HP and Intel to enable their creativity and run their business, and the opportunity to design and sell an exclusive collection on Piperlime.com. The model paired with the winner of Project Runway will receive a fashion spread in Marie Claire magazine and $25,000 from L'Oréal Paris Studio Secrets Professional.
Feeling today, Joshy?
I definitely woke up feeling better. I can really only go up, hopefully.
I'm a little bit hung up from the critique from the judges from the last challenge, and I'm definitely feeling nervous. I wouldn't say that I'm trying to win this challenge as much as I am trying to just get by.
Let the empty bed be our motivation. Let it not be us.
Yeah, it was different to not have Raphael this morning. Yeah. I miss him with his hair.
I wonder what Raphael's doing.
He probably went home to enter the Beyonce lookalike concert.
What happened yesterday with the 6 of us who got chosen was like really unexpected.
Coming in the top 3 sets me up to know that I'm capable of doing this and I'm able to compete with all the other designers. It feels amazing.
And you know we're all after you.
I know. I saw Oliver standing over in the morning with the pillow. The best thing about winning a competition is that you have immunity for the next challenge.
Sorry, Bird, we're going to be your friends. Your evil friends.
Oh, well. The price you pay for being fabulous.
All right, kids.
Ready?
Andiamo.
All right, ladies, let's hit it.
Challenge, we really wanted to find a way to help you unleash your creativity.
Unleash, leash, fetish, S&M.
Tim is going to meet you on 14th Street and Avenue B to fill you in on all of the details. Good luck, and I see you all on the runway. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Good morning, designers.
Morning.
And welcome to Petland Discounts. It's the unconventional challenge, a Project Runway favorite.
Holy crap.
we're dressing dogs.
Oh, no.
I don't have any pets. I have never been into the pet store. I used to have rabbits when I was young, but they all died.
I'd love to say that we're here to get pets for your apartments at the Atlas, but that's not the case. This is the source for the materials for your next challenge. All right. Now, anything in the store is available to you for this challenge, but I want to give you a heads up. The judges do not respond well to looks that come out of unconventional challenges that contain a lot of fabric. However, you may use muslin as the infrastructure for your garment. Your budget is $300. Wow. You have 30 minutes to shop, and your time starts now. Have fun.
I have no plan. I'm going in there, I'm gonna find stuff I like, and I'm gonna work it out.
There's a lot of things like dandruff shampoo for your dog, pet food, filler for your gerbil cage.
Somebody tall.
I guess the live animals are off. Yes, they are. Yeah.
This is crazy, right?
I think this is going to be a good challenge.
I love playful, whimsical, humorous. I don't take fashion too seriously.
What the f*** can I do with food?
Think outside the box.
The dinner box?
I'm not going to where everyone else is going. Everyone heads to the leashes. I'm like, nope.
Oh, leaves. I like leaves.
Everyone heads to the plastic plans. I'm like, definite no. Looking to see what everyone else is not using and do something different from what everyone else is doing.
So, Tim,
yes.
This will be considered fabric, right?
You can buy anything that you want. You just don't want the appearance of your look to be that you took, say, a dog bed and reconstructed it.
Can I get some help getting the dog bed down?
Thank God I've got immunity for this challenge because I don't get into that sort of costumey thing. It's not my strength. Or not my strength, I just don't want to do it. I don't think Michael Kors or Nina want to look at anything that's goofy, so I'm leaving the clown stuff to the other designers.
Designers, 15 minutes.
It's pretty interesting.
The whole rainforest in here.
I like it.
I see these blue filters that are kind of fuzzy that I thought would give some nice texture. I also grabbed puppy wee-wee pads. So they're for training your puppies. They're something that I could probably cut up and make some sort of like flaunt.
I missed my dog. Here she comes. More pet food. A little snack for later.
I think Laura's scoring really big at the pet shop. She has the things they put around a dog's neck if it's scratching itself.
I'm going to make a pet store look as refined as possible.
Designers, time is up.
Oh, for the whole rope thing.
Yeah.
Some interesting choices, I guess.
Thank you, Petland Discount.
I really can't wait to see what everyone does.
All right, designers. You have until 11 o'clock tonight. And very little time tomorrow, so you need to move it. All right, have fun with this. Right. It's a fun challenge.
I wish I would have seen those.
Sorry, girl, I got them.
It's all right. It's okay. You're going to pump my gas one day.
Basically, the paper from the packaging and kind of get it textured. I thought I was happy with the materials, but now looking at it, it's just like, good Lord.
So my plan is birdseed, essentially what I'm going to do is almost look like it's beading to create a pattern on top of the muslin that's going to look like a textile. Something really fitted in the top with a lot of detail, and then counterbalance it with some grass type tiering on the bottom.
I wonder if
you think it's gonna stay.
Food would die then.
No, I'm not gonna dye the food.
Oh,
I like that color. Oh.
Cecilia bought dog food and she's actually gonna glue them on a dress like beads.
Yeah, or she's better.
Sorry.
That thing is loud, Bracey.
I don't know if I'm gonna be able to use that. I always imagine a silhouette first. My plan is to make the base out of muslin, cover the bodice with bedding, and then the skirt will be covered with the wee-wee pads.
I can see right through that.
Really? I didn't plan for that one, Bert.
I am using the largest dog cone collar to create the basis of the skirt. And then I got some aquarium sand. I'm planning on taking glue and covering the bits of the skirt that would be transparent and inappropriate.
Whoever put this on, the mannequin must have been a straight man.
What you gonna do, Bert?
I'm gonna make something.
He's trying to be sneaky.
Can't wait to see what you come up with.
I never use orange, so I have no idea why I grabbed orange. I like all this texture, though.
Feline, this is gonna be up your alley. Very artsy.
I have a lot of pressure on me, because everyone's like, this is totally your challenge. Growing up, my siblings, they were all pretty artsy. My parents let us draw on the walls, we could paint. They were always pretty supportive with art, so I come up with some pretty crazy sometimes. I think I'm good at thinking out of the box, but I don't know what the judges are looking for, so.
We're never gonna know what they're looking for.
Yeah, it's true.
I think more than anything else, the judges are looking for imagination. I got the cat post, I got the doggy bed, and the umbrella. I'm feeling pretty good about what I can come up with.
I'm the extreme opposite of prior things. I was born in Columbus, Ohio. When I was about 16, I moved to London by myself, and later on went to Milan, Italy for university. Just because I lived in so many countries and I've traveled around the world, culture is definitely something that has inspired me greatly.
This is horrible. This is not fashion. This is like trashing.
Oh, wait, are you doing a wee wee pad jacket?
I'm doing wee wee pad crepe dress.
Any wee wee on it?
I'm gonna try to pee on it.
Oh, of course. These must have had tubing connectors, and I didn't buy them.
Connections?
Yeah, like connector pieces.
Oh, like these?
Like those. Yeah, just like those, Victor.
Wow, let the games begin.
I have a very competitive nature.
Weren't you gonna go get lunch? You should probably go eat.
I will. I know I'm gonna win. Here we go.
All right.
Keep your eye on me. I'm gonna rock this challenge out.
Coming up on Project Runway. Are you liking this skirt, though?
It frightens me because I can tell he's frightened as well.
I'm glad I've got immunity. Doo-da, doo-da.
Strange cutting the head off.
Close your eyes while you're doing it.
Today's challenge, we had to go to the pet store and pick out items that we can use to make a garment.
This is gonna be also lunch. Oh boy.
Clean up aisle one. Clean up. I love the unconventional type stuff. I mean, I grew up in the theater, so a lot of my design is very costume based. A lot of people's mottos are less is more, but mine is more is better. New shoes. If you feel like it's too much, add something else. It's in the styling, right?
It is. Yeah. No, it didn't break. Okay, needle didn't break.
You know, we're using unconventional materials and we're using unconventional techniques to apply them. So at this point, everybody is kind of feeling the pressure of, am I going to get done? Is it going to be finished? How is it going to look?
In my mind, Bert, this works.
But in your mind, you're the Queen of Austria.
No, you're the Queen of Austria.
I'm the Queen of England.
I gotta go a little faster.
I don't see any issues with my design, but with the materials and how they're gonna behave, there could be some issues.
I'm looking at the colors of the leaves and I'm thinking this could go really wrong. It could look like some Mother Earth Garden of Eden type thing.
What about your stuff?
I'm using some of this fur stuff to trim and line some things.
I think Josh C. definitely has to step up a little bit just because he got not so much of a good feedback from the judges last time.
So I'm hoping that'll work out.
Ooh.
Oh.
Oh, that looks nice.
Get some texture in there. See the panel on the side there? It's going to be like that, but it's going to be like crystal.
I was raised in a upper-class family. I was able to have brands and access to a lot of fashion. I've been shopping at Neiman's since I was in single digits. That kind of gives me knowledge, knowing that I can't put crap out there and expect people to call it luxury.
Oh my gosh, you guys, we are going to die if people use a lot of this glue. It's pretty heavy duty.
So to create the base of the cone skirt is going pretty well, but the whole test is going to be when the model puts it on and whether it reads classy or assy.
I think it looks cool, and I'm saying it honestly. I'm not going to lie to you. So what's the look going to be?
Basically like a strapless dress, you know? I'm pretty much as lost as everybody else. I make my living as a hairstylist. I'm a self-taught designer, and I just design part-time.
I thought you said you were artsy-craftsy, so won't this be rather easy?
All the contestants were saying that. Like, this is totally your element, which it would be if I had more time. It's kind of like a risk, you know? What you doing, Bert?
Do you remember anything Tim saying not to use or to use? Something about fabric?
The challenge is about using unconventional materials, yet Bert is using the most conventional materials.
I'm glad I've got immunity. Doo-dah, doo-dah.
If you abuse immunity, they will get mad.
See, I was just testing it on this. Let's see, it makes it's pretty.
So time is running short, and I have a lot to do.
Almost like a concept of beating.
Exactly.
I don't know if this time is gonna be enough.
Oh, I love that, Oliver. That's super, super cool.
I saw this wool-like material. And I wanted to make a top out of this. I don't really have an exact plan.
Oliver is very, very skilled, from his tailoring to just a muted color palette. But the dog bed was a little predictable.
I like that the puppy pads are called wee-wee pads.
My biggest fear is how the materials are going to work, because I do have to cut up all those wee-wee pads, and I don't know how they're going to look.
I'm gonna go and dye these.
Victor's using wee-wee pads, and Danielle's using wee-wee pads, so it's gonna be a wee-wee pad fashion show.
At this moment, I'm dyeing the dog pads, and it's just about manipulating them and kind of making them look interesting and textured. This is worse than doing laundry in the river.
How's it going, Bryce?
I have the wee pads, and I'm worried about dyeing those. Is that what Victor
died? That's what Victor died, yeah.
I think Victor's wee wee pad dress is giving me a run for my money. I want to be in the top three this time, so
yeah.
We'll see how this goes. I want to giggle every time I say wee wee pad.
Wow, it's quite a workshop in here. How are you all doing?
Good.
Good. So, what is this?
This is a lot of wee wee pads.
You're kidding. That was once this?
Yes.
Wow, it's like a Depends dress.
Yeah.
You never have to get up from your bar stool.
And it absorbs well.
Bert, hi.
Hey, Tim, how are you?
Congratulations again on your win.
Thank you.
And you have immunity, so you could really do anything you want on this challenge.
I'm trying to do something nice, but I'm not sure.
We just went to a pet store. And how are you able to navigate that pet store and come up with a what looks like a black floor beach cover-up?
Right.
Bert. He is phoning in this nasty-ass dress. It looks like a tacky boudoir thing from the 60s.
They're on such a high with you right now, it could potentially recalibrate their thinking.
Gotcha.
Josh, how are you doing today?
I'm definitely feeling a lot of pressure. Because of the first challenge and with all of the issues surrounding that, I definitely feel like at least this time I'm creating something that's more feminine, more wearable, a little more functional.
What is this?
This was the umbrella. And then I took the cat scratch post and I'm making a belt.
That's great.
You know, the shape and everything is nice. It's a cute dress, but he needs to just pump up the volume for the judges to give them more of a wow factor.
This is beautifully done.
Okay.
Thank you. Let this dictate the rest of what you do.
Cool.
Okay. All right.
Thanks
great.
So much, Tim.
Thank you. Hi, Oliver.
Hi, Tim.
What was this?
I think it was the dog bed.
Oh,
it was,
okay.
I like the tone of this fabric. I thought it looked good from far away. And I also found materials like this thing here. It's sort of like...
Oh, it's pet bedding. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I also got this... It's similar, but it's got a lighter tone. I was thinking of, like, grading out, so starting with a lighter color and then gradually fading to this color.
So an ombre effect.
Yeah, an ombre of that. You don't see a big problem with me using this fabric.
No. And since you're treating the skirt this way, and it's in a very ambitious way, no, it doesn't bother me.
Okay.
No, not at all. Carry on.
Okay.
You have too much going on.
Too much going on?
That's the question for you. Is there too much going on?
Yeah.
I mean, the model's not a mannequin, and if she moves like a mortarboard, I think it's a problem.
The top, I could maybe weave loosely, something like that loose.
Well, I mean, this has the potential for being extremely chic, which is not a word I would associate with a pet store.
This is the Wee Wee Pads. I'm going to cover the bodice with like the bedding for your...
For your bunny. Where that texture meets the our Wee Wee Pads, I haven't said that word so many times in one day ever.
The top is interesting, but where's she going? Why is she going there? In that.
I think I should keep it a clean line.
I just want you to do it.
Just
and
do
I,
it.
As I said, I think you really can.
I'm making a mess. Right?
Well, it's a mess with a purpose.
Are you liking this skirt, though? You know, I want Tim to be like, oh my god, it's a knockout. But essentially, I think he's saying I'm taking a risk because it's not that it's like a for sure the judges are going to love my dog cone collar skirt.
Joshua.
Why don't we start with the sketch so you can get an idea? It's kind of along the lines of this 50s feel, but very updated because of, you know, what I have to work with. I grabbed a lot of the aquarium stuff, but I did not want to go the cliche route and, you know, go right to all the greenery. So I thought I'd use a little bit more of the organic stuff. But what I'm going to be doing with the clear rocks is I really wanted to start heavy on the top of the skirt all around.
You have a ton of work to do.
Josh, he doesn't think less is more, and he thinks more is more, and that can sometimes be detrimental.
And what about the top?
These are actually some dog toys. I had a blue one somewhere. Wait, are you ready for the shoes?
Why not?
Here's the shoes.
I have a question for you.
Sure.
Can this really be executed in the time frame that we have? I mean, my feeling is this. You either take it to where you described it to me, or you revise the whole thing.
This is a gift that Tim is coming over to me, and I'm feeling a little silly based on the fact that I don't have much to show him. It frightens me because I can tell he's frightened as well.
Coming up.
People are gluing like crazy people.
I constantly feel like I'm a freak.
Let's see your button there. Ooh, it's short.
It's gonna look atrocious.
I'm gonna fill in these pieces with various different patches of
There's got to be a simpler way. My brain's starting to bleed just thinking about this. From the back, that looks like a tire track.
No, Tim, that's not the look you're going for.
I responded really well to these materials, and I think I bought all of them.
It looks like it's sprung from the forest.
I am not that inspired by Becky's designs. They are very, homely.
Anthony Ryan, what yes. are you doing?
I didn't want to grab dog bed to use it. I really wanted to show that I can do a garment from birdseed.
I think it's fabulous.
Thank you. For this skirt, I was thinking something with this.
What is little this?
That is bedding for rabbit. It's not the skirt that I'm worried about. I want to get this done tonight because I want it to set overnight.
If you can pull this off, it's going to have a fabulosity.
All right. Thank you.
I think the true thing is going to be in the skirt because I'm going to layer these in so many different, like, over each other.
For the whole skirt?
Yeah. It's a glue gun.
Are you speedy with a glue gun?
I think if I rush through it, it
probably takes... You have to rush. All right, designers. I am hugely enthusiastic about what's happening in here. Work hard. I'll see you in the morning.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you.
So how are the bags working, actually?
He likes the concept of it. It's more of getting done and if it's going to sustain, you know. It could be really cool or it could be really not cool.
Maybe next time we'll actually get to go to Mood.
That would be nice.
Hi, Thais. How are you? It's going to be really simple because it's so... like this, but it'll be
kind of
cool, don't you think?
All right, so let me just pin this and then we'll try it on you. My garment is super duper ooper juper cooper tight.
So as you can see, I still have a lot of work to do. I wish they just leave you with us all night.
You know, I don't want to go on this show and make these costumes.
So I know.
That's the deal. And if they tell me if it's too plain, I'll say, Heidi, this is almost the same silhouette as what you had on last night.
I think that Bert has kind of a crummy attitude. We're all very excited to be here, and Bert seems to be kicking and screaming the whole way.
Simple, simple, simple. Less is more.
We're going to win this. I want to win this one.
This is going to corset you a little bit. It might squeeze you when I tie the thing around.
I'm used to it. Okay. Yeah.
You're like, breathing? What's that? That's okay. In the first challenge, the judges really came down on me about fit. So I'm really just focused on making sure that she looks good this time. We're just going to turn it inside out. We're going to find all the seams. I'm going to fit it up real nice.
Bam. That's smart.
I'm a little behind. I really am. I have a skirt done at this point. And no top. And I'm freaking out. We're trying on the shoes and there's like a whole outfit that I need to do. So I rethink my strategy. I sit down and feasibly say to myself, what can I finish in this amount of time? Stinks when you have to edit a design, but sometimes it just doesn't work, you know?
If I have it stitched all the way down, actually, that would probably work.
So my model comes in and I'm putting this skirt on her. And then I look down and I look at her legs. Yeah, I think it's gonna do what we want it to do. Yeah.
Definitely.
Let's see your button at. Ooh, it's short. Oh, no, 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 no. There's no way the judges would rip me apart. I might have a totally new idea about this skirt. And I might be totally crazy.
See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. My new direction is to work with the aquarium rocks that I had bought instead of the aquarium tubes. I started a great top that was just going to be 100% completely beaded.
You're gluing all of those?
You want me to sew them on?
Yes, girl!
Each one?
This is couture. This is a couture show.
Please.
I am completely throwing away what pretty much has taken up the bulk of my day. So I got these little cat scratcher replacements, and there are tons of these cardboard strips, so I decided to figure out what happens when I try to sew them together. I think this will just be much sleeker, more current, like much better. Much more chic. I'm like, just keep going. That's what you have to do to survive in this competition.
Is it coming together?
Yes. I just wonder if it'll stay glued, right?
I'd be really terrified if I were to use that material.
What?
It's just paper.
You get terrified of a lot of materials, Oliver.
Oliver, I think he has a very sophisticated outlook, very minimal, and he does not compromise, and he definitely has a very high fashion outlook.
Oliver, is the top of that finished? I like it.
Dang.
What's the belt going to be like?
I don't know.
You better figure it out.
Can I tell you something, honestly?
No clutch.
Because she's going to be like this. The clutch. Can they see the clutch? No, well, it's about the clothes.
Check.
I enjoy Joshua. I think he has a great energy. We kind of just hit it off right from the get-go. And I'm really excited to see his outfit for this challenge. Don't give her any accessories. She'll go crazy.
Right up your alley, isn't it, Julie?
What, plasticky paper?
Yeah, like,
I don't really know what's up my alley anymore.
I constantly feel like I'm a freak.
But maybe that's just, you know, maybe I like that.
I think I might have to lose the sleeves because they just may not work.
Bryce, you're looking kind of nice and fluffy up there. I like it.
I'm looking nice and fluffy?
Your skirt's looking fluffy.
I wanted it to be big. It's big.
I think Bryce is in big trouble. I mean, it looks like a dog could walk up on his skirt and pee on it, and it would serve its purpose.
It is a princess.
This is going to read amazing on the runway.
Really?
You understand that? Yeah.
I might understand it tomorrow.
It's going to look good.
What are you going to do for the bottom?
I'm making a...
Oh, you're making a skirt?
Out of this. If I can't get this birdseed glued on here, it's gonna look atrocious. I don't want to go home on the second challenge, you know. I want to be here. This is what I want to do. I don't want to panic, but there may come that point where I am effed. This is for the birds.
You finished?
I don't know. I don't think so, maybe. I'm definitely feeling a little discouraged. I definitely feel like I went down the wrong road when I started looking around the room. I noticed that people are just gluing things on like crazy people. And whether or not people could wear it, you know, it's definitely something to look at, which I think is gonna hurt me in the end.
All right, chickadees, it's 11 o'clock. So let's get out of here.
Okay.
Let's go.
Coming up on Project Runway.
I will be so happy to never see a glue gun for the rest of my life.
Oh my God.
I just don't want to look like the dog on the catwalk.
What a disaster this room is. There's hay, there's hamster bedding, there's sand, there's ropes, there's tubing. It's a hot mess of a room.
I wake up and I kind of had this epiphany that the grass just needs to go. We don't need it looking like a hula skirt. So I've decided that I'm going to cover this entire skirt in birdseed.
Anya, are you in a good place?
All I can do is work. I'm still not even close to having a garment. I mean, it must kind of look like, does this girl know what she's doing? Like, I haven't even done the skirt.
Wow. How is everybody this morning?
Hi.
Joshua, how did you do?
I switched it up.
Oh my God. It's fantastic looking.
Thank you.
Bryce, you did it with the skirt?
The top's a little...
He'll work on it. You have 2 hours to send your models to the L'Oreal Paris makeup room and the Garnier hair studio. Use the Piper Lime accessory wall thoughtfully. Work hard.
Thank you.
I'll see you later.
Oh,
Alberta.
Looks cool, huh?
You like it?
These sleeves are so much cuter, don't you think?
Oliver.
Yes.
Which do you like, here or here?
I like without. I think it's getting too much.
You bugger.
You're glue gunning away, mister. You get that olive ink covered, I think you'll be good, buddy.
I don't know how this is going to end up. To go home over birdseed and hot glue, it would be devastating.
All right, we're going to head to hair and makeup.
We want eyeliner, dangerous eyeliner.
And this bell here is going to go around her waist.
Mm-hmm.
I want her lips to be
that color.
Her
gorgeous
lips.
And rich and beautiful.
Yeah, just like that.
I did a little sketch. I do love this royal blue.
And I was wondering if I can incorporate this on the eyebrow just to put small pieces on. Use
you have medical insurance, right?
Okay.
Wow. I love it.
So I want her to be a little bit rock and roll, a little bit.
Almost Courtney Love, but obviously with dark hair.
Slap that.
Yes.
Something big, like either a French twist or a bun.
Nice. Oh, that's perfect.
Yeah. I want it to be young and casual. Casual, but elegant. I want it elegant. Right.
Like kind of shiny, glossy, flowy.
Shiny hair.
Yeah.
Designers, in 10 minutes, you and your models and I are going down to the runway.
Oh, I will be so happy to never see a glue gun for the rest of my life.
There were some problems here and there, but overall, I'm satisfied with what I have. The dress definitely says something about my identity as a designer.
Yeah.
Hi. Give him a question.
Because I think more than anything else, we just want this to lay flat here.
Yeah.
I feel like what I've made looks really good.
Just be like, boop, boop. Get it, get it.
A show.
Right.
Whether it meets the full criteria of the challenge or not, at least I've made something that's pretty.
I sort of think I'm addicting to gluing these things, so I need to stop at some point. Where Josh kind of played it safe with using conventional fabrics, at least I tried to make it crazy. Isn't it weird? It's pretty weird.
Is it hot?
It's warm, but it's not.
It's not hot.
So I'm going to tack this one, and then we're good.
I want to be able to just get past this challenge. I definitely know that this is not a winning ensemble.
Hasn't Bryce learned yet that they don't do hankies in a wind tunnel?
Oh, my Lord of the Rings. I think Lara, her garment has absolutely no movement. It is just very blah to me.
This really freaking stays glue.
Make sure this kind of pops out.
A garment out of dog food bags. If that's outside the box, then put me back in.
I smell tin.
Don't say that. I know that I'm kind of like performing a miracle in this last few minutes, but I literally am gluing the leashes while she's wearing it. This is madness.
All right, designers and models, let's go down to the runway.
These unconventional materials are so unstable. I'm just praying nothing falls down.
Smashing, smashing.
I just don't want to look like the dog on the catwalk.
Is that it? That is a Project Runway record.
Coming up on Project Runway.
I want to pee all over those wee wee pad.
You've got to have like candy corn teeth to wear that dress.
It's bad. That's a big problem.
Welcome to the runway. As you know, in fashion, one day you're in, and the next day, you're out. There are 15 of you here, and after tonight, there will be 14. We asked you to create a look using materials from a pet store. You had $300 and one day to put it together. This is really an opportunity for you to show us your innovation and creativity. And I'm really excited to see what you've put together. The winner of this challenge will receive immunity and cannot be eliminated on the next challenge. All right, let's meet the judges. First, we have CFTA Lifetime Achievement Award winner Michael Kors.
Hey, guys.
Michael.
Hi.
Fashion Director for Marie Claire Magazine, Nina Garcia.
Hi, Nina. Hi.
And our guest judge for today, fashion designer and founder of Alice and Olivia, Stacey Bendit.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi.
We will score your designs as they come down the runway. One of you will be named the winner, and one of you will be out. Let's start the show.
I'm excited to see the look. I think it got pulled together very nicely. I'm hoping the judges like how I use the materials. Garment wasn't like the most interesting thing on the runway, but considering the time and all of my troubles I went through, I think I did a pretty good job.
I'm excited to see it go down. I achieved the effect that I wanted. I mean, who would think you're gonna make a dress out of birdseed and have it look so expensive? You know, I couldn't be happier.
My dress is very, very simple. I like it a lot, and I think it looks beautiful and very elegant and very chic. Does it meet the challenge requirements? No. So thankfully, I have immunity for this challenge.
It's a little Shirley MacLaine playing a part of a hooker.
I think my dress looks great. It was kind of military-ish, but woven with dog tags. I love the back. I like the stripes. I like the silhouette. I just wish it wasn't so weird.
My model looked like a completely different girl. She just looked so strong and edgy and just everything that I wanted. I thought it looked fantastic. I was absolutely thrilled.
When I'm watching the garment go down the runway, I like the movement, but I'm really worried about the look. I can tell that the bodice is still not where it should be. I feel like I might be in some trouble.
I am very pleased with the way it looks. It looks very architectural, which is what I wanted to do with the aquarium hosing. It's not entirely what I wanted, but it worked out very, very well.
A huge improvement from the first challenge, but it's not got the wow factor that some of the other designs have, which does make me nervous.
Work. I'm feeling pretty confident just because I know my garment looks very well done. It might not be the loudest or the most designy, but it has elements that are pretty modern and tasteful.
I can't believe that's me.
As my model is coming down the runway with a dress made out of hamster bedding,
You cannot tell that this is not fabric. And she looks so chic and expensive. It was like, wow, that's just hamster bedding.
I feel extremely happy with how my garment looks on the runway. This is the moment that you can show people your creation and that they thought that moment was magical. I almost feel emotional.
I'm really excited about the dress. I put the feathers up near the top to give it more of an edge. But I've got this crazy riot of colors, so I'm a little worried that maybe I stand out in a bad way. But I'm pretty satisfied with what I have.
Nice.
I'm really happy with how it turned out. I think I made a chic-looking garment that looks like it could be worn in everyday life. I was one of the only people to not use a single piece of fabric, so I think that's something that's pretty impressive about mine.
She looks smashing. I think the look came out perfectly. I'm unconventional. I use the weirdest products. I'm so proud of my look. This challenge is mine. I'm taking it home, and no one's gonna take that from me.
If I call your name, please step forward. Danielle. Julie. Laura. Victor. Becky, please step forward. Cecilia. Kimberly. Anya. Bert, please step forward. If I've called your name, congratulations. Your scores have qualified you to move on to the next challenge. But before you leave, I have one thing to say. Bert, You are so lucky this week that you have immunity. What do you have to say?
I agree.
Thank you. You guys can leave the runway.
So who do we think is on top?
Oliver.
A lot of work.
Anthony.
Josh M.
I wonder what's gonna happen with Josh C though,
because it's too.
I don't think it was necessarily like bad. I think it was a little bit boring.
Safe.
Yeah, he put puppies on the puppies.
I think Bryce is gone. The pee pads were pee pads.
Yeah.
When it walked out, Michael was going like this. And I was like, okay. Feline's in the bottom, I think, but I don't think she's going to go.
No. Not compared to those other two.
No.
Right. Anyway.
The rest of you have the highest and the lowest scores. One of you will be named the winner. And one of you will be out. Bryce. Tell us about your look, and please tell us about the material.
The bodice here is like the rabbit hamster type bedding, and the skirt is the puppy pee pads.
I've been sitting in this chair for a lot of time, and we have seen more ugly napkin clothes over the years.
What did I say right here?
Yeah.
I don't know how many times we have had this tissue dress.
It just never looks right. I don't love the fit of the top. And the styling is making it even worse. She's got sunglasses on, or she's incognito in napkins. There's nothing interesting about it.
She looks like she's from the Blue Man Group. Then you decided to do a lot of texture on top. And then something very voluminous in the bottom. It's just an explosion of everything. There is no
balance here.
There was something kind of pretty about the texture of the top, but then the fit's not great, and I'm not really a fan of voluminous wee-wee pads.
You know what I also love about this challenge so much, and what most of you guys do so well, is that you manipulate this material so far. But, you know, you can immediately tell what it is. Like, it's straight up ripped up wee-wee pads.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
And who is this girl? Where is she going?
I don't know.
That's a big problem. Anthony Ryan.
Upon walking into Petland, everyone goes for the dog leashes, so my mode of thinking is go in the opposite direction. So I took it upon myself to not pick something that was a textile in the store. So everything is seeds. So this is the result, you know, my human bird feeder, I guess.
I like this dress a lot. I like the silhouette. She looks very strong and modern. You know, I like what it does around her face. You're the only one that used seeds. And I think that's really cool. Kind of looks like a beaded embroidered dress. It's very short.
Yeah, I chopped off the bottom. I bought some grass for it, put it up next to it, and I was like, ooh, overkill.
I love this. It was actually one of the few styles that I looked at and said, I'm not really sure what that is, but it's really interesting. And it had like a nice little glimmer to it and an interesting texture. And I thought the shape was really great. And it had a chicness to it. I thought you did a great job.
Thank you.
She could walk into a party wearing that dress, hopefully without a lot of birds nearby.
Right.
And people would say, oh, she looks really chic.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'd think,
what is
that? That bird seed? Like, what is she wearing? And that, I think, is so much what this challenge is about.
Right.
I think it's beautiful. The collar is very dramatic, but yet it's very simple. I love the touch of the belt. It is just right. It's dramatic but simple. Really well done.
Thank
Beautiful.
You. Thank you all so much.
Oliver.
Well, first of all, this thing is covered up like a dog's couch or bed. And then this is pine wood for hamster's bedding. And this is for rabbit's bedding. And this thing is the piping for the fish tank. I stuff the sponges for the fish tank
right
into the skirt to make the volume a bit more dramatic.
I really love this look. I think the way that you combine the texture with that very simple yet dramatic shape worked very well. I love the little plastic band that gives it that modern touch. It would be very editorial. And it would be something that we would photograph in a minute.
Thank you.
I love the ombre. It's really, really chic. And I think the silhouette's terrific. It's interesting and exciting, but it's actually beautiful. And I think it has a sense of tailoring. So to find a way to make something that has an understated chic to it and has a tailored edge, it's not the first thing that comes to mind when you walk into a pet shop. So I think the dress is really great, and it's really an interesting use of materials.
Thank you.
If you think about the materials that were available and what you've done to them, you manipulated them in a way that she looks sophisticated.
Thank you.
I think it's fabulous. I mean, I never thought I would say I liked anything made out of, like, hamster filling. And I actually am sort of into the dog bed top. It really came together very well. It's definitely one of those styles that you look at and you're kind of like, what did he make that out of? I'm not a fan of the eyebrows.
I understand you wanted the drama. I got it. But to me, it looks more like she was out in the cold and her eyebrow froze. It's distracting, that's all.
Josh Christensen.
I saw an umbrella hanging from the ceiling. It had a really cool print on it of puppies, and so I colored it, reversed it, and turned it so it kind of gave it a more, like, watercolor kind of effect. This is a reptile cage, the black part, and then I used finishings from collars and leashes.
So this is an umbrella for pets?
Yeah.
See, that's where, for me, the problem is with your outfit. It's too much of a...
normal material.
Normal material, you mm-hmm. know?
The word for today's challenge is unconventional.
Sure.
You picked the most conventional materials, and then you put them in conventional shapes. This really misses the mark in every way as far as thinking outside the box. Even the way the top is cut makes you look kind of like, you know, you're nursing triplets. I don't know, it's just off.
You know, it's not terrible, but it's just okay. It's not, wow.
Sure.
You'd see this girl in like a college bar or something. It's like there's nothing really fashion about it. And then it's too much with like the shoe pattern and the, you know, kind of kimono-y belt. And I didn't think the fit was great. And this just tried to play it too safe.
Joshua McKinley.
I caught a glimpse of this reptarium. And then I realized I want to do this wrap skirt. And I had draped this amazing top. I wanted to show the bare midriff a little bit. I thought it was a great juxtaposition of this high-waisted, kind of a 50s circle skirt. And these are actually all aquarium rocks.
Did you make that pattern?
Yes. I just tried to manipulate it where it started from the green-blue, melded to the purple, and finished up with the purple.
It's colorful. It looks beautiful. The skirt is a nice length. I like that you gave it that circle shape. I don't understand what that tag is on the side.
It's for your parrot to look at itself. Oh. I just thought it was an interesting touch for myself.
I love it. I think it's a great look. It's really modern, unique. I just want to give her a good wash, though. I want to wash her face off.
Yeah.
You know, the outfit is colorful enough, and it's just too much.
I love what you did with the top. I was waiting for someone to use, like, aquarium pieces because they're so sparkly and beautiful, and I love sparkle. I think you did a beautiful job with the clothing, but then with the accessories, you made her, like, just too vampy.
I mean, you've got a fabulous-looking outfit here.
Thank you.
It's dramatic.
Mm-hmm.
So to turn her into Sea Vixen Barbie...
Okay.
You don't need it.
Okay. Did you put a hair roller on the heel?
That's actually a dog toy that I cut both the ends off of.
Oh, it's a dog toy.
It's just a lot. The only time you need to do too many accessories is if it's a big bore. But this isn't a big bore. You've got something really wonderful.
Thank you.
Feline.
So my look is hippie chic. I use the sea kelp from aquariums that are plastic pieces. Then I use the dog bed at the top here.
The silhouette for me is too simple.
Yeah.
You know, there's not much going on the top or on the bottom. There's nothing that excites me about it either.
I do agree with you, actually. I've been hating this thing the whole time just because it's so not what I wanted.
You know, I think that what bothers me the most is the colors.
Yeah.
The color combination is really...
like Halloween.
Yeah, it looks... yeah. A little dated, it looks bad. And then the accessorizing. You see how short her torso looks with that big belt? This girl looks like she has
a boob in a skirt.
Yes, boobs and then skirt.
Yeah. Accessories should help the garment, not hurt it.
Yeah.
I've noticed that you are agreeing with us a lot.
I'm not going to defend it because I believe I can do better, so.
I have to say, there's nothing interesting about the materials. I mean, she truly looks like, you know, she's at an autumn harvest festival. She's like Miss Pumpkin. And you knew it. That's what's so crazy.
I'm sorry.
You're sitting here telling us that you knew it.
Like, hey, this was a pet store challenge. Like,
I know.
When I see something so out there, I just think you could have done something more interesting, like a ball gown covered in, like, little, like, you know, kitten toys. That would have been fun.
I feel like that could have easily got me eliminated, though.
And you think this is going well?
Okay. We've heard what you had to say. I'm going to have a little chat, and then I call you back on the runway. Thank you.
Hey!
I didn't get that great of feedback.
You didn't?
No. I want a do-over.
I think they're confused of you because I think they didn't get why you went through all this and then ended up hating it.
I just was uninspired by the materials I got.
I think excuses are for the birds.
Yeah, I know.
It wasn't as terrible as last time. They're like, it's nice, and but you used material.
Like it was safe.
Yeah.
I'm just mad at myself because I just went with that project and I didn't come up for air. And
that's the thing, like not coming up for air.
Like seriously, like I don't need any pep talks and I don't need to be told like what to do. I've already been told by Nina Garcia I'm upset. No, I don't need to hear it.
If you totally like are defensive, like you come off like kind of like bratty and not open to what they have to say.
To get cut this short is just, it would kill me.
Let's talk about the designers that we didn't like. Joshua C.
I don't think it could get more boring.
He took an umbrella, used it as fabric.
What are you doing? Using fabric. I don't know. There's something so boring about this that it makes it ugly. Exactly. Like, it's just literally, like, I kept thinking, like, 1990s bar scene.
The funny thing is, his main issue, unfortunately, was that he just wanted to make clothes that actually fit his model.
Worst outfit is Bryce. That is the worst outfit I have seen in a long time.
I could puke already from seeing the napkin thing.
I want to pee all over the weeby pad.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, it's hideous.
Well, it was supposed to be fun and creative.
Exactly. To think that that is cool, I don't understand it at all.
Feline.
It's just boring.
It was boring.
Guys.
It's just boring.
And the colors were terrible.
Oh, the colors are hideous. You've got to have like candy corn teeth to wear that dress.
Yeah. She looks so dated.
Proportions.
It's bad.
She thought it was ugly. I mean, she literally told us it's ugly.
Exactly.
It's a standoff for who's the most boring.
Let's talk about the designers that we loved.
Joshua M.
Yeah.
I loved all the aquarium jewels on that top. And I thought the skirt was great looking.
I was actually surprised that he would choose this kind of skirt because it was similar to the top, you know? But then I kind of liked that it was not, you know, like a tight fit.
It wasn't expected. I thought the proportions actually were kind of neat. And a lot of people seem to be doing that tight little mini skirt. So I thought that was interesting.
I like that sporty detail. For example, that little blue ribbon on the waist. I like the fact that he made that pattern out of those colors. But I did think the accessorizing killed it.
Anthony Ryan completely made something so different than anyone else on that runway. And I just love how he could manipulate it so much to make it not look like birdseeds. She just looked really modern.
There was the issue of the length.
Me too.
Yeah.
You know, had that been a little longer, it would have been perfect.
So do you like Oliver's outfit more than Anthony Ryan's outfit?
Oh, yes.
Really? I don't.
I do. I just think it is more sophisticated. It is more elegant. And it feels more modern.
There was a sophistication to Oliver's. It was really beautiful and it was so chic. But the fit wasn't quite as perfect as on Anthony's.
You mean on the top?
Yeah, it was like a little dumpy.
If you are busty, I don't know that a Sherpa top is the easiest thing to fit. But I love the proportion of what he did. What's funny about it is both of these dresses, they could technically be in the same fashion show.
Yes. They almost went together.
Yeah. Same family.
Same family.
I think Anthony Ryan really embraced the challenge.
I think Oliver did too. Sorry, but
I mean, he ombre'd a hamster chin.
I gave him a good score. It's not that I don't love him, but if you put those two next to each other, birdseeds win.
Sorry, but the length is not good. It's not elegant.
Oh, no.
It's a standoff.
Here it goes again.
Yeah.
Getting hot.
It is getting hot.
I'm going through menopause.
All right. I have a really good idea.
I love
Can
that.
Can we put the hamster chip skirt with the birdseed top?
I love that. Realistically, I think they're both fabulous. I think one could have lost the eyebrow and one needed a longer hemline.
Yeah.
Those are two things that I think, you know, are a problem. I think it's very close, though.
The six of you represent the best and the worst. One of you will be named the winner, and one of you will be out. One of you will be named the winner, and one of you will be out. Oliver, you are the winner of this challenge. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
That also means that you have immunity for the next challenge, and you cannot be eliminated.
I'll only look harder.
Congratulations. You can leave the runway.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Winning the challenge, it feels fantastic. Having that acknowledgement was really nice.
Winner!
I am proud to have presented that look.
Yeah.
I thought it was so beautiful and chic.
It was very, very good. Well done. Looking forward, there's going to be more to come. And so it only made me more ready and more prepared.
Anthony Ryan. To be honest, your look was my favorite. But I was overruled. You're in. You can leave the runway.
Thank you.
Joshua McKinley, you're in. You can leave the runway.
Thank you very much.
Bryce, you're in. You can leave the runway. Faleen, Josh, one of you will be out. Faleen, your outfit was boring and your color palette did not work at all. If you're not happy with your work and you cannot defend it, how can you possibly expect us to?
I don't know. I mean, I'm pretty disappointed.
Josh, again, you're on the bottom, and there's a good reason. This is the unconventional challenge, but you showed us no imagination. And we question if we want to see more from you. Josh. You're out. Faleen. That means you're in. You can leave the runway.
Congrats.
Thank you. Oh, Jossie! I went such the wrong way.
Brush it off.
Yeah. I never thought I would be the one to cry, but seriously, you guys, it's intense.
Thanks again. Thank you. Really. Thank you.
I would have really liked to have dodged another bullet and come back to try another day.
Oh, worst day ever.
Whether it was not as innovative or creative, I at least put something down the runway that made my model feel good and look good.
You keep going.
Listen,
you know this is
he's
not
going
stop
to.
It.
Here. I just have to say, everybody, fabulous. I'm choking up. It was a fabulous show. You should feel extremely proud about what you achieved, and I mean that. Extremely proud.
Thank you.
Yes. I have to send you the blueprint to clean up your space.
Of course.
Okay. Josh, we're going to miss you.
Hi, Josh.
Bye.
Stay happy, you guys. Keep working
hard. Thank you.
We love you, Josh.
With these experiences and this knowledge, I definitely feel like I can move forward and accomplish great things. I think you'll definitely see me in the future. I don't know when, but it won't be that far off.
Next time on Project Runway.
Hi, guys. What?
The bigness of it is very exciting to me.
You will be divided into teams of two.
You act like a small kid, like you don't let me
No, talk. You're getting confused. No.
I think we're all feeling tense.
This jacket has taken you over 12 hours and...
It looks great.
She was rocking my nerves.
We're headed to our first outdoor runway ever.
I'm sort of freaking out.
You're gonna be fine.
It looks like a bad costume.
This has no effort put into it.
This was the worst look. Who do you think should go home?
Visit MyLifetime.com to learn more about the fashion you've seen on tonight's show.
Runway. Today is the final casting call for Project Runway.
20 people are coming, but only 16 will make the competition.
Do you support yourself by being a designer?
I do. I guess I would rather be poor and hungry than go back to my previous career.
Which was?
Banking.
When did you learn how to sew?
I just learned.
So you just learned how to sew?
Stopped designing about 1992. I was fortunate enough to work for three of America's top designers, Bill Blass, Arnold Skazi, and Alston. I'm sober now about almost 3 years, and it's wonderful designing again.
I think you just have to be careful to not be too simple.
Congratulations. You're all now our designers for Project Runway.
Rise and shine, everyone. What you were wearing and the one sheet that you brought are the materials for this challenge.
Oh my God. I'm having problems with my model. There was definitely some fit issues.
Is that a toilet?
The pants are off-putting.
She's wearing like a Flintstone disco pouch.
You are in a competition, and you are going to show me a pair of white shorts and a tank top.
Bert, you are the winner of this challenge.
I won.
Really? Josh, you're in, but barely. A fail. That means you're out.
This
is the search for the next big fashion designer.
Yes.
16 designers.
It's about style.
Fashion.
Attitude.
How do I have attitude? Attitude.
3 finals. I would wear that.
I think it's fantastic.
Well, let me see you put it on.
Keep me out of this.
And 1 winner.
This is for real.
Be good.
Be great.
This is Project Runway.
The winner of Project Runway will receive $100,000 from L'Oréal Paris to start their own line, the fashion spread in Marie Claire magazine, a $50,000 technology suite from HP and Intel to enable their creativity and run their business, and the opportunity to design and sell an exclusive collection on Piperlime.com. The model paired with the winner of Project Runway will receive the fashion spread in Marie Claire magazine and $25,000 from L'Oréal Paris Studio Secrets Professional.
Feeling today, Joshy?
I definitely woke up feeling better. I can really only go up, hopefully.
I'm a little bit hung up from the critique from the judges from the last challenge, and I'm definitely feeling nervous. I wouldn't say that I'm trying to win this challenge as much as I am trying to just get by.
Let the empty bed be our motivation. Let it not be us.
Yeah, it was... different to not have Raphael this morning. Yeah. I miss him and his hair.
I wonder what Raphael's doing.
He probably went home.
to enter the Beyonce lookalike concert.
What happened yesterday with the six of us who got chosen was like really unexpected.
Coming in the top three sets me up to know that I'm capable of doing this and I'm able to compete with all the other designers. It feels amazing.
And you know we're all after you.
I know. I saw Oliver standing over in the morning with the pillow. The best thing about winning a competition is that you have immunity for the next challenge.
Sorry, Bird, we're going to be your friends. Your evil friends.
Oh, well. The price you pay for being valuable.
All right, kids.
Ready?
Andiamo.
All right, ladies, let's hit it.
Challenge, we really wanted to find a way to help you unleash your creativity.
Unleash, leash, fetish, S&M.
Tim is going to meet you on 14th Street and Avenue B to fill you in on all of the details. Good luck, and I'll see you all on the runway. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Good morning, designers.
Morning.
And welcome to Petland Discounts. It's the unconventional challenge, a Project Runway favorite.
Holy crap. We're dressing dogs.
Oh, no.
I don't have any pets. I have never been into the pet store. I used to have rabbits when I was young, but they all died.
I love to say that we're here to get pets for your apartments at the Atlas, but that's not the case. This is the source for the materials for your next challenge. All right. Now, anything in the store is available to you for this challenge, but I want to give you a heads up. The judges do not respond well to looks that come out of unconventional challenges that contain a lot of fabric. However, you may use muslin as the infrastructure for your garment. Your budget is $300. Wow. You have 30 minutes to shop, and your time starts now.
Have fun. I have no plan. I'm going in there, I'm gonna find stuff I like, and I'm gonna work it out.
There's a lot of things like dandruff shampoo for your dog, pet food, filler for your gerbil cage.
Somebody tall.
I guess the live animals are off. Yes, they are. Yes.
This is crazy, right?
I think this is going to be a good challenge.
I love playful, whimsical, humorous. I don't take fashion too seriously.
What the f*** can I do with food?
Think outside the box.
The dinner box?
I'm not going to where everyone else is going. Everyone heads to the leashes. I'm like, nope.
Oh, leaves. I like leaves.
Everyone heads to the plastic plans. I'm like, definite no. Looking to see what everyone else is not using and do something different from what everyone else is doing.
So, Tim,
yes.
This will be considered fabric, right?
You can buy anything that you want. You just don't want the appearance of your look to be that you took, say, a dog bed and reconstructed it.
Can I get some help getting the dog bed down?
Thank God I've got immunity for this challenge because I don't get into that sort of costumey thing. It's not my strength. Or not my strength, I just don't want to do it. I don't think Michael Kors or Nina want to look at anything that's goofy, so I'm leaving the clown stuff to the other designers.
Designers, 15 minutes.
This could be interesting.
The whole rainforest in here.
I like it.
I see these blue filters that are kind of fuzzy that I thought would give some nice texture. I also grab puppy wee-wee pads. So they're for training your puppies. They're something that I could probably cut up and make some sort of like flount.
I miss my dog. Here she comes. More pet food. A little snack for later. I think Laura's scoring really big at the pet shop. She has the things they put around a dog's neck if it's scratching itself.
I'm going to make a pet store look as refined as possible.
Designers, time is up.
Going for the whole rope thing.
Yeah.
Some interesting choices, I guess.
Thank you, Petland Discount.
I really can't wait to see what everyone does.
All right, designers. You have until 11 o'clock tonight. And very little time tomorrow, so you need to move it. All right, have fun with this. Right. It's a fun challenge.
I wish I would have seen those.
Sorry, girl, I got them.
It's all right. It's okay. You're going to pump my gas one day.
Basically, the paper from the packaging and kind of get it textured. I thought I was happy with the materials, but now looking at it, it's just like, good Lord.
So my plan is birdseed. Essentially, what I'm going to do is almost look like it's beading to create a pattern on top of the muslin that's going to look like a textile. Something really fitted in the top with a lot of detail, and then counterbalance it with some grass type tiering on the bottom.
I wonder if you think it's gonna stay.
Food would die then.
No, I'm not gonna dye the food.
Oh,
I like that color. Oh.
Cecilia bought dog food and she's actually gonna glue them on a dress like beads.
Yeah, oh, she's better.
Yeah,
sorry.
That thing is loud, Bracey.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to use that. I always imagine a silhouette first. My plan is to make the base out of muslin, cover the bodice with bedding, and then the skirt will be covered with the wee-wee pads.
I can see right through that.
Really? I didn't plan for that one, Bert. I am using the largest dog cone collar to create the basis of the skirt. And then I got some aquarium sand. I'm planning on taking glue and covering the bits of the skirt that would be transparent and inappropriate.
Whoever put this on, the mannequin must have been a straight man.
What you gonna do, Bert?
I'm gonna make something.
He's trying to be sneaky.
Can't wait to see what you come up with. I never use orange, so I have no idea why I grabbed orange. I like all this texture, though.
Feline, this is gonna be up your alley. Very artsy.
I have a lot of pressure on me, because everyone's like, this is totally your challenge. Growing up, my siblings, they were all pretty artsy. My parents let us draw on the walls, we could paint. They were always pretty supportive with art, so I come up with some pretty crazy sometimes. I think I'm good at thinking out of the box, but I don't know what the judges are looking for, so.
We're never gonna know what they're looking for.
Yeah, it's true.
I think more than anything else, the judges are looking for imagination. I got the cat post, I got the doggy bed, and the umbrella. I'm feeling pretty good about what I can come up with.
I'm the extreme opposite of prior things. I was born in Columbus, Ohio. When I was about 16, I moved to London by myself, and later on went to Milan, Italy for university. Just because I lived in so many countries and I've traveled around the world, culture is definitely something that has inspired me greatly. This is horrible. This is not fashion. This is like trashing.
Oh, wait, are you doing a wee wee pad jacket?
I'm doing wee wee pad crepe dress.
Any wee wee on it?
I'm gonna try to pee on it.
Oh, of course. These must have had tubing connectors, and I didn't buy them.
Connections?
Yeah, like connector pieces.
Oh, like these?
Like those. Yeah, just like those, Victor.
Wow, let the games begin.
I have a very competitive nature.
Weren't you gonna go get lunch? You should probably go eat.
I will. I know I'm gonna win. Here we go.
All right.
Keep your eye on me. I'm gonna rock this challenge out.
Coming up on Project Runway.
Are you liking this skirt, though?
It frightens me because I can tell he's frightened as well.
I'm glad I've got immunity. Doo-da, doo-da.
Strange cutting the head off.
Close your eyes while you do it.
Today's challenge, we had to go to the pet store and pick out items that we can use to make a garment.
This is gonna be also lunch.
Oh boy.
Clean up aisle one. Clean up. I love the unconventional type stuff. I mean, I grew up in the theater, so a lot of my design is very costume based. A lot of people's mottos are less is more, but mine is more is better. New shoes. If you feel like it's too much, add something else. It's in the styling, right?
It is.
Yeah. No, it didn't break. Okay, needle didn't break.
You know, we're using unconventional materials and we're using unconventional techniques to apply them. So at this point, everybody is kind of feeling the pressure of, am I going to get done? Is it going to be finished? How is it going to look?
In my mind, Bert, this works.
But in your mind, you're the Queen of Austria.
No, you're the Queen of Austria.
I'm the Queen of England.
I gotta go a little faster.
I don't see any issues with my design, but with the materials and how they're going to behave, there could be some issues.
I'm looking at the colors of the leaves and I'm thinking this could go really wrong. It could look like some Mother Earth Garden of Eden type thing.
What about your stuff?
I'm using some of this fur stuff to trim and line some things. I think Josh C. definitely has to step up a little bit just because he got not so much of a good feedback from the judges last time. So I'm hoping that'll work out. Ooh.
Oh.
Oh, that looks nice.
Get some texture in there. See the panel on the side there? It's going to be like that, but it's going to be like crystal.
I was raised in a upper-class family. I was able to have brands and access to a lot of fashion. I've been shopping at Neiman's since I was in single digits. That kind of gives me knowledge, knowing that I can't put crap out there and expect people to call it luxury.
Oh my gosh, you guys, we are going to die if people use a lot of this glue. It's pretty heavy duty. So to create the base of the cone skirt is going pretty well, but the whole test is going to be when the model puts it on and whether it reads classy or assy.
I think it looks cool, and I'm saying it honestly. I'm not going to lie to you. So what's the look gonna be?
Basically like a strapless dress, you know? I'm pretty much as lost as everybody else. I make my living as a hairstylist. I'm a self-taught designer, and I just design part-time.
I thought you said you were artsy-craftsy, so won't this be rather easy?
All the contestants were saying that. Like, this is totally your element, which it would be if I had more time. It's kind of like a risk, you know? What you doing, Bert?
Do you remember anything Tim's saying? Not to use or to use? Something about fabric?
The challenge is about using unconventional materials, yet Bert is using the most conventional materials.
I'm glad I've got immunity. Doo-da, doo-da.
If you abuse immunity, they will get mad.
See, I was just testing it on this. Let's see, it makes it's pretty. So time is running short, and I have a lot to do.
Almost like a concept of beating.
Exactly.
I don't know if this time is gonna be enough.
Oh, I love that, Oliver. That's super, super cool. I saw this wool-like material, and I wanted to make a top out of this. I don't really have an exact plan.
Oliver is very, very skilled, from his tailoring to just muted color palette. But the dog bed was a little predictable.
I like that the puppy pads are called wee-wee pads.
My biggest fear is how the materials are going to work, because I do have to cut up all those wee-wee pads, and I don't know how they're going to look.
I'm going to go and dye these.
Victor's using wee-wee pads, and Danielle's using wee-wee pads, so it's going to be a wee-wee pad fashion show.
At this moment, I'm dyeing the dog pads, and it's just about manipulating them and kind of making them look interesting and textured.
This is worse than doing laundry in the river.
How's it going, Bryce?
I have the wee pads, and I'm worried about dying those. Is that what Victor
died? That's what Victor died, yeah.
I think Victor's wee-wee pad dress is giving me a run for my money. I want to be in the top three this time, so
yeah.
We'll see how this goes. I want to giggle every time I say wee-wee pad.
Wow, it's quite a workshop in here. How are you all doing?
Good.
Good. So, what is this?
This is a lot of wee-wee pads.
You're kidding. That was once this?
Yes.
Wow, it's like a Depends dress.
Yeah.
You never have to get up from your bar stool.
And it absorbs well.
Bert, hi.
Hey, Tim, how are you?
Congratulations again on your win.
Thank you.
And you have immunity, so you could really do anything you want on this challenge.
I'm trying to do something nice, but I'm not sure.
Well, we just went to a pet store.
Uh-huh.
And how were you able to navigate that pet store and come up with what looks like a black floor beach cover-up?
Right.
Bert, he is phoning in this nasty-ass dress. It looks like a tacky boudoir thing from the 60s.
They're on such a high with you right now,
mm-hmm.
It could potentially recalibrate their thinking.
Gotcha.
Josh, how are you doing today?
I'm definitely feeling a lot of pressure. Because of the first challenge and with all the issues surrounding that, I definitely feel like at least this time I'm creating something that's more feminine, more wearable, a little more functional.
What is this?
This was the umbrella. And then I took the cat scratch post and I'm making a belt.
That's great.
You know, the shape and everything is nice. It's a cute dress, but yes. He needs to just pump up the volume for the judges to give them more of a wow factor.
This is beautifully done.
Okay.
Thank you. And let this dictate the rest of what you do.
Cool.
Okay? All right,
thanks
great.
So much, Tim.
Thank you.